Go ahead.
Forgiving is something that easy to say but not simple to do. As Ephesians 4 verse 31 to 32 said that, get rid of all the bitterness, rage and anger, brawling and slander, along with every form of malice. Be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other just as in Christ God forgave you. In order to know more about the members and the word forgiveness, I will walk you through some brief information about the books of Ephesians. The book of Ephesians were written by Paul while he was in a prison in Rome around the time of 60 to 62 AD. The books, Bible History Online said that the books were written for the church at Ephesus, basically for the Ephesians. And the book have three main themes. First, Christ reconciled himself with the church, and he reunited all the people from the other nation. And the third one, Christ won the Christians live as a new people. As my members, Ephesians 4 verse 31 to 32, it's about forgiveness, and basically it said people should get rid of the bitterness, rage and anger, brawling and slander, along with the form of malice, so that we can forgive each other. But where can we get the power of forgiving while forgiving is hard and difficult? Pastor Littleton said that we can forgive others because Christ forgave us and Jesus forgave us on cross. So that's what Ephesians 4 verse 31 to 32 is about, and that's also what Paul wants us to know. Moreover, there are some other verses in the Bible, in the books of Bible, which also talk about forgiveness. James 5 verse 16 is telling us that we should acknowledge that we have sins against God and against other people. We have to admit those sins, and we have to ask for the forgiveness of God. And Matthew 6 verse 14 to 15 is the most popular verse for forgiveness in the book of Bible. Said that, for if you forgive other people when they sin against you, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive others their sins, your Father will not forgive your sins. We have to know that we not deserve to have the forgiveness of God, so we should forgive others, even though they are not deserve our forgiveness. But if we forgive them, God will forgive us too. And thus, the God's forgiveness empowers to forgive other people. And Jesus also prayed for us and for our forgiveness, as Luke 23 verse 34 said that, Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing. He died for our forgiveness. He prayed for the Roman soldier who put him to death, for the valet who condemned him to death, for the Jewish leaders who succeeded him to death, and for Judas who betrayed him, and for the rest of us who do sins. Forgiveness is not only happened in the Bible, but it also happened in our real life. There are a lot of forgiving stories, and this story is one of them. Robert Roos was the father of Linda Roos, who was killed by the Green River Killer, Gary Ridgway, in the early of 1980s. And the court then happened on December 18th of 2003, while other victims' family members blaming him and judging him because of what he did, Robert Roos stood out and said to him that he's not one of them who hate him, but he forgave him because God forgives him, because God forgave us, so he also wants to forgive Ridgway. And I have a video which also told you about the court. Thank you.
us at all for what he had done. You know, he killed so many people, he didn't know who they were, what they looked like. And I just couldn't believe that somebody could kill all those people and not remember their
name. Neither could the angry relatives of his victims, who were invited to speak in court when Ridgway was sentenced to life without parole on December 18, 2003.
You had said your memory, when it comes to all of the women you took, was gone. Our memory is not. In your words, you said that we didn't mean anything to you, but she meant everything to us.
She was a mother, she was a wife, she was a sister, and we miss her.
Gary Ridgway sat there stone-faced as victims' relatives damned him and mocked him.
Bloody animal. I wish for him to have a long, suffering, cruel death.
He's gonna go to hell and that's where he belongs.
But then the emotionless facade finally cracked when the father of one of his victims appeared to surprise him with a dose of human kindness.
Mr. Ridgway, there are people here that hate you. I'm not one of them. You made it difficult to live up to what I believe, and that is what God says to do. That's to forgive. You are forgiven, sir.
Forgiving, I have the handout which provides more information about the shooter and the serial case is caused. You can get it later, get it back to you. Forgiving and being forgiven are all amazing and also the hardest thing to commit. So, however, no matter what you have done and what you are going to do, acknowledge that you are doing sins and committed to God. So you will be forgiven. To the unbelievers, commit your sins to another, hearing your confessions and forgive them so that you can find peace in your mind. As Ephesians 4 verse 31 to 32, you should get rid of the bad temper, be kind to one another, and forgive them. Forgiveness is something really hard to do, but God always forgives us. So he empowers us to forgive other people. I hope after my explanations about Ephesians 4 verse 31 to 32, we are able to understand more about the forgiveness God gave us and the forgiveness we should give to others.
Thank you very much. Let's give a round of applause.